A longtime familiar face in Milwaukee makes a couple high-profile return trips, and he is not mincing words about what he likes and what he doesn't like. New at 10, 12 News, Kathy Mykleby catches up with former Mayor John Norquist.
Here's my ticket. No free rides.
Catching up with a former mayor of Milwaukee ahead of hopping on the train to Chicago is a bit of a flashback.
Now I'm on to something else.
Back in 2004, 6 months after he left his top job at City Hall amid a sexual harassment scandal, we took the same Amtrak line to catch up on John Norquist's then new job. Today, he is still leading the nonprofit Congress of New Urbanism.
I'm basically doing the same stuff I was doing as mayor, only now I do it all over the world.
Including recent high-profile stops in his old stomping grounds. On this day, he was the guest of the Granville Brown Deer Chamber.
I give you the Honorable John Norquist, the former mayor of the city of Milwaukee. John?
He promotes neighborhood and economic development going hand in hand, echoing how cities here and everywhere can adapt, thrive, and excel, facilitating growth across the board.
Everybody wants more money. You know, what are the things you can do? Well, you can change the rules.
His message is familiar. Reacting to recent praise in Milwaukee, his demeanor remains wry.
I got the Daniel Burnham Visionary Award. And my eyesight isn't even that good.
At the 20-year celebration of Milwaukee's Riverwalk District, Norquist says he shared the glory with Mayor Henry Meyer when accepting the Visionary Award, named for a famous architect. The district's commercial, residential, pedestrian traffic development stretches from the historic Third Ward to Schlitz Park and development of the Beer Line neighborhood. Norquist has been keeping track.
I really like what happened north of downtown on the river. There's a lot of real estate value for the city. One estimate is $700 million in real estate value added along the Milwaukee River. So that's all tax base. People come from all over the world to look at the Beer Line, to see how real estate value was created in an old city with a city that's got all the problems that cities can have, but it's really worked out well.
He has been openly blunt about how much of a waste he considers the cost and the course of the Marquette interchange.
It was built way too big. It was a waste of money. It didn't add value. It was the highway traffic engineers got their way, and it was basically $800-900 million that could have been $200 million. It could have just fixed it on the same pattern that it was. You spend all your money on an interstate, you don't have the money for the streets. I never saw a sidewalk cafe along an interstate.
As for the fierce politics in the state, he says he's been there.
There's an intoxication with power.
The former state senator recalls his days of fighting with the other side.
We were both arrogant. You know, we look back on it and say, how could we have been so arrogant? You know, we had all that power and we let it go to our heads. And that happens in the legislature, and I see that now. It's rare that people come along and really handle it well.
Do you care if Milwaukee's on the right track?
Oh, sure. I live in Chicago now, but I love Milwaukee, and I really enjoyed living here. We're enjoying things. My wife has a good job in Chicago. We both have a good job in Chicago.
Their son and daughter are in school close to home. Norquist believes Milwaukee is in good shape, better off than other cities, but would get a big boost if trains between Milwaukee and Chicago ran 11 instead of 7 times a day.
You'd have an extra 5,000 high-income Chicago downtown people buying property here.
It was time for Norquist to run off and catch the train home. Make no mistake, he says he's not running for any public office anywhere.
He's not running for anything.
Nope.
Kathy Mykleby, WISN 12 News, Milwaukee.
Norquist says he believes Tom Barrett is doing a fine job as mayor and had high praise for the police chief also.